My basketball coach always emphasized that on fast breaks, players without the ball should run wide. The increased distance between the offensive players makes it more difficult for one defender to guard multiple players. But it also takes more time to run out wide, which gives the defense more time to set up and get more defenders down the court. So wouldn't it be better to take the shortest path and run down the middle of the court? Then I'd have a better chance of beating the defensive players before they get in position. Am I right, or is my coach right? Let's do the math and find out. First, there are times when running down the middle is the right choice. For example, here, when the ball ends up wide, then you can still spread the floor and get a good angle for a pass. Or of course, if you're the one with the ball and you can beat people to the basket. But let's focus on the more common situation when the ball is coming up the middle. Let's set up a typical situation for my playing days. I'm a low post player, so I was often near the basket on defense. If we got the ball and I ran wide for the fast break, I'd travel a path like this. My defender, on the other hand, would run straight down the court to try to help stop a basket, and in particular, stop me from getting a layup. How much further do I have to run than my defender? And if we run about the same speed, does that give my defender enough time to stop, turn around, and be prepared to stop me? Here are a couple fast breaks that show how hard it is to stop a good fast break even if a defender or two has beat the ball down the court. So the defense doesn't just need to beat the ball down the court, but they need time to stop, turn around, and set up. Back to our fast break situation. We will model my path as a parabola, and I can have GeoGebra find the parabola that goes through these three points. I've scaled the court so that units are feet, but we will put up the metric measurements on the screen as well while we work. To answer our question, we need information about the distance that I run and my defender runs. We also need some information about the speeds basketball players run down the court, because our question is really about the time my defender has to set up, and with distance and speed, we can calculate the time. Let's start with the distances. The distance my defender runs is easy to calculate, and GeoGebra can do that for us. The distance is about 70.2 feet, or 21.4 meters. What about the distance I would run? Well, that's not so straightforward, pun intended. If you've seen our arc length video, then you've seen how we could use an integral to calculate the arc length of curves. We did this by chopping up the curve into small sections and approximated the section of the curve with a straight line. We used the slope and the line segment and the Pythagorean theorem to calculate the length of the segment, then added it all up. We strongly encourage you to go watch the video because we didn't do it justice here. The link's in the description. In the end, we developed this formula for calculating the arc length. We can have GeoGebra or other programs help us out here to do the actual computations. The endpoints of the integration interval are the x-coordinates of these two points, a negative 33 and a 37. These will be the bounds for our integral. We can write the integral as the square root of 1 plus the derivative of our function squared times dx. GeoGebra gives the value of the length as 76.5 feet, or 23.3 meters, so I have to travel 6.3 feet more than my defender, or 1.9 more meters, so my defender can definitely beat me to the spot. But the defender has to slow down and turn around to get in good defensive position. If he doesn't, then he has a good chance of fouling me on the layup. So let's calculate how much time we will each take. Me to get to the basket, my defender to get to his spot, turned and planted. I watched some video to get an idea of how fast basketball players run on fast breaks. Values around 20 feet per second, or 6 meters per second, were typical. If I ran the entire length of my curved path at that rate, it would take me 3.83 seconds. For my defender, it would take him 3.51 seconds. But that doesn't count his time to slow down. Let's assume he starts slowing down at the free throw line in order to turn around. That'll take him some time. Let's assume that his average rate from the free throw line to the block is half of the top speed of 20 feet per second, or 6 meters per second. Then we can calculate how much time it takes my defender to get into a good defensive position. It takes 2.81 seconds to get to the free throw line at 20 feet per second, and another 1.4 seconds to get to the block and turn around and get set. That's a total of 4.2 seconds, which is much longer than my 3.83 seconds. So that means he's well short of having enough time to get set up to stop me. This means I have time to go wide, make it hard for the defense to defend us, and my defender still doesn't have time to beat me down the court and get ready to stop. Turns out, my coach was right in telling me to get wide on my fast breaks. Like in the last video about arc length, we see that the lengths of curves can be deceptive. It looks to me like my path is longer than 6.3 feet more than my defender's. The rule of thumb that we're bumping into is that with just a little bit more length in a curved path, you buy yourself a huge advantage in other places, like spacing the floor, or easy passing angles, or maintaining speed to avoid obstacles. This is something to consider in other sports too. Going around one player in pursuit of the ball or another player won't add much more distance and could be to your advantage if you're able to maintain a higher speed during the pursuit because you're avoiding an obstacle. I mentioned in the previous video that long distance runners shouldn't worry about running out and around the pack in a straightaway, or moving out just to keep some space because the extra distance they add to the run is almost negligible. I calculated the added distance for a runner to run the 100 meter straightaway, but going out 3 meters near the middle, then back again. If they follow a parabolic arc, it's about 0.24 meters, or about the length of an average female's running shoe. Now running on the outside around the curve might be a different story, but you don't need calculus to do that calculation. We leave this following problem as an exercise to the viewer. How much further does a racer run on a regular 400 meter track if they're 1 meter further out on the turn than another runner? You can look up the radius of the circular part of the track online to help you figure this out. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.